This is absolute definitive cheating.
Dr. Matthew Webb is a 31-year-old Army doctor accepted into one of the military's largest medical residency programs, a San Antonio, Texas-based complex that includes the renowned Brooke Army Medical Center, where Webb trained as a resident. But it wasn't long before he was stunned to learn an open secret about most of his fellow doctors. They were, he says, cheating to pass medical exams.
It wasn't until I took my physics exam that I found out that the way the residents were studying for the exam was to actually study from verbatim recalled back tests that had been performed by prior residents.
To become certified by the American Board of Radiology, or ABR, doctors must pass two written exams and an oral exam. Webb says he took that first exam in the fall of 2008, and to his surprise, he failed the first test, which focuses on physics. He says he went to the director of the radiology program at the time.
He told me that if you want to pass the ABR physics exam, you absolutely have to use the recalls. And I told him, sir, I believe that's cheating. I don't believe in doing that. I can do it on my own. He then went on to tell me, you have to use the recalls, almost as if it was a direct order.
And an order easily fulfilled. Webb found the recalls, the tests almost verbatim, on the military's website for the radiology residents. CNN has obtained all of these tests, at least 15 years of recalls, stored on a shared military computer server. The test questions, the answers, even presented as a PowerPoint. Cultivated from years of residents taking tests, recalling the questions, and adding them to what appears to be an ever-growing database, a glorified cheat sheet.
Residents knew about the recalls. The program directors knew about the recalls. A large portion of people were using them, and it was just accepted.
That bothered Webb. Not only was this cheating, this was the Army. But he says his supervisors in uniform didn't seem to care. So Webb took his complaint of cheating to the very board that certifies radiologists. Dr. Gary Becker is the American Board of Radiology's executive director.
We've heard about these, you know, recall memories come out of the test, write down 20 questions here, you take the next 20 questions. They almost sound like well-organized schemes to skirt the very certification you're trying to ensure.
I don't think we know how well organized they are. I mean, we have inferential evidence.
Isn't it cheating?
We would call it cheating, and our exam security policy would call it cheating, yes.
And now, for the first time in more than 10 years, the board is revamping its entire testing procedures, at the same time cracking down because so many certified radiologists may have gained their certification, at least partially, because it was so easy to cheat. Right now, about half of the written test questions are the same every year.
We take it seriously, because when we put the stamp of certification on an individual, that means that the public has trusted us to do so.
And from any of the investigations or inquiries you've done, you don't really have a sense of how long it's been going on?
No. It's been going on a long time, I know. I can't give you a date.
Because this goes right to the heart of the value of the certification.
This is exactly what it's all about.
We showed Becker copies of the recall exams from the military's San Antonio program.
We're outraged by this, and we took this case to our professionalism committee. The result of the deliberations there and the decision of the board was to go directly back to the training director, the dean of the institution, and we've had those discussions.
He acknowledged the recalls were very close to the actual test.
In fact, I think you even have them sign a statement that they know that this material is copyrighted.
That's correct.
And
that's where the illegal comes in.
Right.
That's exactly right.
So it would be a crime.
It would be a crime.
Despite repeated requests, the military refused to answer our questions on camera. It did send us a statement acknowledging residents shared exam questions in the past, and it does not encourage or condone cheating of any kind. The military also admitted some faculty members and program directors were aware of the use of recalled examination questions by residents, In fact, the military admits a smaller number of faculty and a past program leader encouraged the use of recall questions as one of several tools to improve medical knowledge and prepare for the exam. The military now says the recall exams have been removed from its computers, and residents must sign this statement that they won't use them. But has the damage already been done?
Dr. Webb, the complainant, he told us that to find out that some of these physicians don't have the knowledge but are able to still get through by cheating, it's despicable. Do you agree with it?
I agree. Now, I can say we don't have any more information on other programs. We haven't heard similar reports from other residents. But if and when we ever hear of any, we're going to track them down.
We wanted to find out just how widespread the use of recalls really is. So we figured we'd come here to Chicago, to the largest medical convention in the United States, the Radiological Society of North America, which draws 60,000 radiologists from around the world.
It wasn't long before we started getting answers.